everyone, welcome back to my channel. So many of you have requested for me to do this, so I'm doing it. I'm reviewing The Poppy War by R.F. Kuang. I'm going to try and keep this as coherent a review as I possibly can, but know going into this that I love this book. Like, it's only July, this is my favorite book of 2018. I have read it 3 times. You will probably be judging me pretty intensely if you have read this book by me saying that, but it's been a long time since I have read a book that has hit this hard, and I just think that it's extremely important. It's so poignant. Okay, let me get into thoughts. Be like one of those actual book reviewers and like put the book on my shelf right there. Do you like the aesthetic? Do you like it? Okay, so basic overview and forewarning for this book. So this is an own voices adult epic fantasy that is heavily inspired by Chinese history, primarily the Nanking Massacre or the Rape of Nanking. So with that being said, this is a dark story. This book comes with content warning. There is extremely graphic genocide, warfare, mass killings, abuse of all kinds, sexual, emotional, animal, etc. Rape, drug use, addiction, self-harm, racism. Basically, pretty much almost any sort of trigger warning that you can place on a book is in this book. I am one of those people that I'm kind of drawn to very dark and disturbing books because that's just the type of person that I am. So I have read a lot of very dark things that are very triggering. I'm pretty sure this is the first book that I've ever actually had to put down and take a minute for. Like, it gives me chills thinking about certain scenes. It's rough. And it should be taken extremely seriously. If any of those things are worrisome for you, skip chapter 21 or tread lightly. So if you're like me, you see things like that and you instantly want to read it. So with that being said, heed those content warnings, proceed with caution, and let me tell you about the story now. In the story, our main protagonist is Rin, who grew up in a poor family from a poor town. And her family basically decides that it would be best for the family for her to be married off. As in, they can make money from an arranged marriage, and Rin wants nothing to do with this. Obviously. Who would? So Rin goes to a local librarian, I guess you could call him, and basically begs for him to help her study for this exam. There is an exam that takes place in this world where pretty much anybody who is young in the teenage years or whatever can take it to potentially get accepted into prestigious academies. So Rin studies her butt off. It is very apparent from the beginning of the story how hard the work is in this world. It's not sugarcoated, it's not glossed over. She works hard. Not only does she pass this exam, but she gets accepted into the most prestigious military academy ever, basically. So she basically packs up her life and moves to this military academy and is ready to leave her life behind. But when she gets there, she kind of gets her first glimpse of how tough the world is and how poor she really was. This is her first glimpse into severe prejudice, and everybody who is at this military academy is coming from the top of the top elite classes, and she just basically tested in because she was incredibly book smart. So she starts to deal with prejudice at the school, and that's her first impression of kind of the darkness that exists in the world. So the first thing that I liked about this book was it had similar vibes in the schooling system as The Magicians trilogy by Lev Grossman, where it's a very prestigious academy that teaches military and warfare and martial arts and some form of, I don't want to say magic, I'll get into that a little bit later, but it's a brutally honest take on the kind of academy or school setting in a fantasy story where the work is hard, the work is grueling, and it shows how tough the people actually have to be. Nobody is a special snowflake, nobody gets easy treatment in this school, everybody works their ass off to be here. So Rin hits some bumps along the way just between her and her classmates and her accepting that while she studied and passed this exam when nobody else could, she is now amongst other people who did that and she is not the smartest among them, which I personally really like seeing that in fantasy stories. I like when the protagonist actually has to struggle and work really hard to succeed and that everything isn't handed to her. And that is kind of an underlying tone in the entire story. We start with a very juvenile perspective of what you are willing to sacrifice and what pain you are willing to endure to reach your end goal. And as the story progresses, it goes from a small kind of teenage school atmosphere, which is not to be taken lightly. It's a very brutal atmosphere, but it just kind of expands as the world expands. But that's kind of an underlying theme through the entire story, is pain and sacrifice and what someone is willing to go through to see their goals met. So while you were at the school, the students who make it through the first year basically get to pledge with a specific teacher or tutor in a specific field. So whether that is like military tactics or martial arts, strategy, things of that nature. So getting into kind of the final bit of like spoilery type things, this is just kind of the very beginning. This is like glossing the surface of the story, so somewhat spoilery, but important to the synopsis. Rin ends up working with a very eccentric teacher who has not taken on a student in years. He basically just seems like a pothead, is what he appears to be. And she ends up working with him, and he rejects her, obstacles happen, but Rin ends up pledging lore, which is a topic that nobody has ever pledged before, and it basically is the study of using opiates and drugs to be able to communicate with the gods and goddesses. So, as you can see, drug use is fairly common in this story, but it has both a positive and a negative use in this story. They use it to kind of transcend and communicate with gods, and this expands the story even further. It kind of focuses on benefits that they can provide, but it also focuses on the horrendous drug addiction that you can face if you're studying this subject. So that is basically part one of the story. I believe there are 5 parts in this book, so this is just setting the tone. The story from there expands further and further. So we basically start in her little poor town, she expands to this prestigious military academy, and then from there it expands into actual military practice, and from there it expands into all-out country-to-country warfare, and by the end we are kind of in all-out worldwide warfare. So the story scales seemingly quickly, but at the same time it passes very fluidly. And that is going to be kind of all that I talk about as far as synopsis go, because I feel like this is a story that's very hard to define. That's kind of the basic plot path that it's going to follow, but from there it gets into a lot more brutal human nature and the dark roads that people can go down when faced with very brutal circumstances. This book, like I said, follows the theme of pain and sacrifice of the human spirit, like what somebody is willing to endure and what is worth enduring for an end goal. But it also is a study on kind of like human nature, that nobody is black or white. Everybody is in a moral gray ground, and Rin follows pretty precariously on that line for a majority of the story. She kind of teeters over the line both ways as the story progresses, and you're kind of rooting for her in both ways. Like, you want to see her go down the dark path because really messed up things happen to her, but at the same time, when she has these really dark thoughts, you're like, yes, but at the same time you're like, wait, that's kind of messed up. You don't want to do that. You really see kind of the human nature of her develop and grow based on the horrible circumstances that her life has presented her. And that kind of comes back to the content warnings. There are very severe things that happen in this story. There are very brutal and gruesome scenes that happen. But I'm in the corner that I think a lot of those scenes are necessary. A lot of people think that this is just going to be grim dark and it's going to be just unnecessarily disturbing. Not only does this detail a lot of actual historical events that happened in Chinese history, this basically scales everything to the degree of what human nature can be pushed to, faced with really disturbing things that happen to them or around them. So I think that these events, while they're incredibly hard to read about and while they're incredibly brutal to see somebody experience, it's incredibly necessary to the story. I don't think that it should have been sugarcoated any more than it was. Not that it was in any way, it was brutal, but I just think that it kind of gives you a stronger understanding of the scale that these people are working on. So those are my overall thoughts on like the basic story. This is a debut novel, and let me tell you, it does not read like a debut novel. This book is breathtaking. It hooks you from the start. People who don't read fantasy pick this up and can't put it down. It's just so deliciously written. The prose is beautiful. It hovers in the moral gray ground the entire time, so you're not quite sure which way it's gonna go. And I do believe this is going to be a trilogy. I think it's confirmed that it's going to be 3 books. I know book 2 is already written, and they were waiting to kind of see how it was received. It was clearly received very well. I think I have yet to see anybody give this less than 5 stars. I personally think that it is one of the best fantasy stories that I have ever read. I put this up there with The Name of the Wind, The Magician's Trilogy, and for my own personal guilty pleasure, Akamath, just because this is the first book since I read Akamath that I actually turned over and started rereading the second that I finished it. I wanted nothing to do with the real world or any other fictional world. I just wanted to stay in this world and with Rin and just root for her. So that was a very long-winded review and thoughts of the book. I basically think that this is possibly the best book that has come out this year. I highly recommend it, but I highly recommend going into it with the content warnings very vivid in your mind, because it's a very, very dark story. I personally loved it. I know that it's not going to be for everybody, so I'm not going to just kind of recommend it to everybody, but if it's at all intriguing to you, or if you think that historically influenced fantasy stories are important, I recommend this, because this touches on things that have actually happened in our world. So as brutal as it seems, it's based on the brutality of humans that have existed. So take that as you will. I highly recommend it. It's my top book of the year. I hope I piqued some of your interest, or at least enlightened you guys to what the story is about that you've been seeing around a lot, and I will see you guys in my next video.